on time. No see.
The craziest thing. I'm walking out of Papagino's and I ran into Naomi.
You're like 2 hours late, man.
No.
It's 12:30.
Oh, wow. Anyways, I was just picking up the pizza here. I got extra cheese when I ran into Naomi.
Who is Naomi?
Naomi, from 10th grade, from Miss Parsons' history class. Naomi, lesbian. How do I know this? 'Cause she said, "Hey Matt, how are you? How's the acting doing?" And I go, "Can't complain, Naomi, how are you?" And she goes, "Fine, I work in Radio Shack in Arlington, and I'm a lesbian." Just like that, I know. So then I go, "Oh, Radio Shack, that's cool." And then I left.
So it took you 2 hours to get a pizza.
Well, yeah, the talking to Naomi and the drive there and the drive back, and I had to find parking off 128th and parking here, and I sort of had this thing first.
What thing?
Nothing, just this audition thing.
Audition for what?
For nothing. You don't know Shepard? Sam Shepard.
Yeah, of course.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, he was in the Pelican Brief with the wrinkles. I love that guy. Is he in the play?
No, he wrote the play. It's this play called Buried Child, won a Pulitzer.
What's the part?
Vince?
No, what kind of part is it? Is it good?
Yeah, no, Ben, they were looking for a blonde.
Dark blonde? Because you're not blonde.
I mean, that's where I was, man.
I just wanted the book so I could go ahead and get started.
Sorry.
Are you gonna help?
Oh, well, give the book.
You read and I'll type.
Thanks. I gotta get something to drink.
Oh, no, I got it. Here you go.
Thanks.
So I thought we could get started with the Stradlater Holden scene that starts on like page 37. You read the dialogue, I'll type it in over here. And as before, please spell any words you think I might have difficulty with.
Page 37. Here we go. Holden. She had a real lousy childhood. Lousy is L-O-U-S, no E, Y, childhood. I ought to go down and say hello to her at least. New line, Stradlater. Why the hell don't you then, instead of keep saying it?
Why the hell
don't you? D O N apostrophe T C H A. Then instead of keep saying it. I can't believe they give out Oscars for this.
Give out what?
Oscars for adapted screenplay. Are you sure it works this way?
Uh-huh.
Why exactly are you sure, Ben?
Huh?
I mean, you haven't taken any, like, screenwriting classes or anything, have you?
Wait, is this from the book?
No, I'm talking.
We don't have time for creative talking.
I mean, why do you think this movie is yet to be made, Ben?
Because no one's tried?
It's a pretty popular book, Ben.
Okay, well, we haven't tried.
I mean, doesn't it bother you that the best thing you can produce is just a reproduction of someone else's work?
That I can produce and you're just, like, hanging out?
No, I'm helping out. It doesn't matter. It bothers me a little.
Why? It's a great book.
It's someone else's book.
It's famous.
Come on!
It's public.
It's stealing.
Adaptation is the highest form of flattery.
Imitation?
Imitation. Adaptation, yes. And that's when it happened.
Was
or where it came from.
I was scared.
That was scared. really scared.
Yeah, for good reason. And that's when I realized.
After we searched the entire apartment.
There was no one here. And we didn't have to whisper anymore, and we could actually talk in our normal voices.
But just to make sure no one was there, we actually talked a lot louder than normal. Hey, where'd this come from?
I don't know, but it fell right next to my gun.
The mystery begins. We knew we had to open it, but who would do the honors?
No way.
So I did it. Goodwill Hunting.
By Matt Damon.
And Ben Affleck. We wrote a script. Finished?
Stop. This is an excellent script. This is the best script I've ever read. If Ben put this here as a joke, then I have severely underestimated his talent.
Check this out.
Ben did not write this. I'm done.
It's so good.
It's really good.
It's so good. It's so good. It's so good.
Ben, don't hit me.
I'm sorry.
I'm littler than you.
I know. It's so good.
It's almost like too good, man.
Casey, you will not believe what just happened
Ben.
To us. We're sitting on the couch
Ben,
and
hang up.
What?
Hang up the phone.
Why?
Hang up the phone.
Casey, there's like this weird thing with a call happening. We might get disconnected. Yeah, it's weird. Okay. I gotta talk to you later. Okay, love you. Bye. What the hell was that about?
You can't just tell everyone, Ben.
He's my brother.
This is very confusing. We don't need to involve anyone else.
What's confusing?
Ben, where do you think this script came from?
The hand of God? Where do you think?
I also think God. Don't you find that strange?
Yeah.
It's amazing.
It's a blessing.
It's a gift. Unless
what?
Have you ever done anything really bad?
It's not a curse.
Why not?
Because it's not.
It could be a test. Like Job, who brags about his family and gets plagued by boils and locusts.
But what do we have to brag about?
Come on. We're white, we're American, we're male. We were in school ties, damn.
It's definitely not a curse.
Maybe not a curse, but a test. Think about it. All you and I want is
meatball subs.
Not right this instant.
Okay. Cable TV.
More long term.
Sony PlayStation.
Sony PlayStation? No.
I don't know. Money, an Oscar, a girlfriend would be nice, or Casey to like lose his speech impediment.
Exactly. Sex, fame, riches. Those are all sins. We're supposed to say no to this. We're supposed to take this script and get rid of it.
Absolutely not. I hope you're joking.
Think about this. Why do we deserve this? Exactly. We don't. It's a test. Don't you see? It's just like Job.
We're nothing like Job.
Not literally, but metaphorically. Like in terms of a metaphor.
I know metaphors.
No, if I were to say like or as, then I would be using a simile.
I know what a simile is too. I just don't know what you're talking about since none of that stuff happened to us.
That's why it's a metaphor. It's not an exact replica of the situation. It's a comparison.
I know what a metaphor is.
Apparently not.
What is your problem?
My problem is that every time I try to talk to you about something serious.
You mean something La La Land?
Something serious. You don't even have the vocabulary to discuss it.
That's not true.
Yes, it is. You dismiss everything, every conversation, if it has even slightly complex ramifications.
Okay, Matt, let's have it your way. Let's have Matt Damon serious time. Ooh, I'm so scared of this spooky little script. I mean, it's paper bound together with a cover on it. What are we going to do? I mean, what are we going to do?
Wow, man, you're just, like, proving my point. With every word, you're just proving my point. I mean, you're proving...
Proving my point.
This isn't a joke, Ben.
I know.
Do you?
Yeah, to be honest, I'm not the one who's screwing around here.
Oh, yeah?
I mean, what is the point of this conversation? We're not gonna throw it away. I'm not gonna let you. Anyways, Matt, if we're cursed, we're cursed. We can't just, like, throw it in the garbage and then the garbage is cursed because the garbage is on the floor of the apartment where we live. So, yeah, you could take it out to some dump, which will be somewhere near us, and still on the planet Earth. So, unless you want to invent some, like, rocket ship or something and, like, hover above the crust of the Earth. But, like, anyways, the point is, we can't move away from this or away from this, whatever you want to do. Your name is on it, my name is on it, and we just have to deal with it.
I guess.
And the curse is always wondering about it later if we don't do it.
That's true.
Okay?
Yeah, it's just...
Matt!
Then we're going to need to do it right.
Of course.
And that's going to be difficult.
Yes.
We're going to need to get a director and...
Oh my god.
And the right location, yes. And casting. And we're going to need a crew. Do you know any grips? Do we need more than one grip? Grips?
I don't know.
Ben, are you even listening to me?
Yes.
No, you're not.
Well, you're just preaching to my face about how to make a movie. I've been in a movie before.
But you haven't made a movie.
Neither have you.
Exactly. So this is going to be difficult, and we should both acknowledge that this kind of thing doesn't happen to just everyone.
Okay, I will. I gotcha.
You will what?
I will be perfect. I will make this perfect movie with you.
That's not what I mean.
Well, then what do you mean? What? Okay?
Okay, what?
I'm ready. Let's work.
Really?
Yeah.
My god, we're doing this. You know what this means.
I do.
We're gonna be famous.
Totally famous.
I'm gonna meet Steven Spielberg.
Yeah, you are.
I'm gonna meet Scorsese.
True that. I'm gonna meet Daisy Fuentes.
Daisy Fuentes?
Yeah. I like Latin women.
Okay. Do you have to go to the bathroom?
I should go.
Matt Damon? No, I can't actually speak up right now. I have a callback this afternoon at 4. Yeah, for Vince. But I don't think I'm gonna be able to get there until... Excuse me? No, I know I need to be there. I want to be there. I'm kicking myself, but if I can just be seen a bit later... Huh? He did? I got it? No. Yes, that's good. That's great. So, I will definitely be there. I just, maybe a bit late. Never mind. I'll see what for. Thank you so much.
Who are you gonna see at four?
My mom? My mother, why?
No reason, you have to leave at four?
Yeah, I have to. It's this thing for my mom. It's kind of big.
Bigger than the script falling from the sky, or?
Yes, Ben. Believe it or not, there is life outside of this apartment, and it's hard, and real people have to deal with real hard things, Ben.
What are you talking about?
What am I talking about? What are you talking about? Take a look at yourself, man. I'm sorry, man. It's just this personal health issue of my mom's.
Oh, man, that's rough.
Well,
Matt, you should go see your mom.
Oh, it's okay. I mean, I'm sure she's being a bit melodramatic. I'm gonna go see her. Let's get back to work.
You say so.
Where were we?
Page 37?
Okay. All right, 37. Quick cut to Will, walking across Harvard Yard.
Oh, no. 37 and Catcher.
Wait, you still want to do that?
Yeah.
Catcher.
Yeah, like you said, we need to commit ourselves to what we started.
Right.
I mean, if we adapt Catcher, everyone will believe we could have done that, so we'll finish it by next week, shop it around, it'll get picked up. Here, I'll make a schedule. Today is Saturday. I think we can get 5 or 6 good hours of work in tonight if we stay focused.
Oh my god, my head!
What?
Oh, one of my migraines!
You get migraines?
Yes. Remember?
Yes!
Remember?
Okay, what do you need?
What have you got?
Tylenol, Advil, aspirin, Bayer, Aleve, Excedrin, Tylenol PM, Bufferin, and Motrin.
What the fun? Did you say Advil?
Yeah.
Did you say Nuprin?
No. Do they even sell that anymore?
Yes! Come on, Nuprin! That's all I need!
Okay, I'll run out and get you some.
Yeah, I'll pay you back later, man.
Yeah, don't sweat it. Hey, man, how's your head?
Better? Yeah. I had something to eat, took a nap.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
Alright, so big breakup scene, right? Skylar's dorm, page 76. Here we go.
You know what? Let's do it on our feet.
Yeah?
Yeah, let's get the blood moving, see how it feels.
Okay, let's say I'll play Will, and you can play Skylar.
Do you want English Skylar or regular Skylar?
No.
Right.
Okay.
Come on, go.
I'm not honest. Is that what this is about? You want to hear that I don't really have any brothers, that I'm an orphan? Is that what you want to hear?
Yes, Will.
No, you don't want to hear that.
Yes, I do, Will.
You don't want to hear that I got cigarettes put on me when I was a little kid, that this isn't surgery. Will lifts his shirt, revealing a 6-inch scar on his torso. You don't want to hear that. Don't tell me you want to hear that.
Yes, I do, Will.
What, you want to come in here and save me? Is there a sign on my back? Is that what you want to do? Do you? Don't bullshit me. Don't you dare bullshit me.
You know what I want to hear? I want to hear that you don't love me. If you tell me that, then I'll leave you alone. I won't ask any questions and I won't be in your life.
Will looks Skylar dead in the eye, lowers his hand. I don't love you. Oh my god!
That is a damn good scene.
Yeah?
Yeah, and you read it really well.
Thanks. That I don't love you at the end. Oh man.
It's so raw. Can I give it a go?
Sure.
Is that okay?
Yeah, I mean, we have a lot to do, but... No, it's okay. If you want to do it right now, that's fine. Here you go.
I'm not honest. Is that what this is about? You want to hear that I don't really have any brothers, that I am an orphan? Is that what you want to hear?
Yes, Will.
No, you don't want to hear that.
Yes, I do, Will.
You don't want to hear that I got cigarettes put out on me when I was a little kid, that this isn't surgery. Will lifts his shirt, revealing a 6-inch scar on his torso. You don't want to hear that. Don't tell me you want to hear that.
Yes, I do, Will.
What? You want to come in here and save me? Is there a sign on my back? Is that what you want to do? Do you? Don't bullshit me. Don't you dare bullshit me.
No. I want to hear that you don't love me. If you tell me that, then I'll leave you alone. I won't ask any questions, and I won't be in your life.
I don't love you!
Ben!
What?
What is wrong with you?
What?
You don't throw a chair.
No, Will is really upset.
Are you kidding me?
No, it's the first time he's talked about his childhood.
Fine, but he's not psychotic. Plus, the chair.
Forget about the chair. The scene is so incredibly intense.
Why would he throw a chair in the middle of Skylar's dorm?
Because he's got a temper?
No.
What do you mean, no? I wanted to try it out, so we try it out.
No, I mean, the idea is terrible. Will isn't gonna do that because it's insane. Look, it doesn't go with the whole tone of his character. Will is a smart guy, but he's not cocky about it. He's got turmoil, but that stays beneath the surface. Come on, he loves her. He just doesn't know how to say it. He doesn't want her to think he's, like, whipped or something, you know? I mean, he doesn't even want to be in love because it makes him seem weak. And if there is one thing Will Hunting doesn't want to do, it's seem weak. He's saying, I don't love you at the end, not because he is in love with Skylar, but because he's trying to be strong.
Okay, well, that all makes good sense, so I guess I can just go to hell. I mean, this is bullshit, man. These aren't your decisions to make.
Well, someone has to make them.
Oh, and that someone is you?
Yes, Ben, it is.
Why?
Because I know what the hell I'm talking about.
Oh, that's right, Matt. I mean, give me a break, man. I appreciate this deep psychological attachment you've developed for Will over the past, what, like 3 hours? But you're not the only person involved. I mean, this is my goddamn apartment, and that is my name on the script.
Yeah, right after mine.
Are you nuts? It says Matt Damon and Ben Affleck. And. Not with Ben Affleck, not occasionally including Ben Affleck.
And my name is first on the script. That's context clues, Ben.
Are you seriously kidding me? Look, I can't take you. Let's just flip a stupid coin.
What?
That's fair, right?
No.
Your call.
Heads.
Heads, it's you.
Good.
Fine.
Sorry. I guess we should move ahead then. I guess we should just move forward. Do you want to do 2 out of 3?
No.
Really? You don't mind?
Really? You don't mind?
Oh, come on.
Oh, come on.
Oh, I really sound like that.
Oh, I really sound like that.
You are such a loser, Ben.
I'm Matt Damon. I get everything I want. Hey, Ben, 2 out of 3? 2 out of 3? How about 2 out of 3?
Wow, Ben, that's an excellent impersonation of me. You are a good actor.
Wow, Ben, that's a...
Stop! Stop! Look, we made a decision. I think we should try to be professional and move on.
Okay. I just want to say one more thing about this, and this is the absolute last thing I say, I'll promise. Here it is. If that coin had come up tails, you would have made me keep flipping until it came up heads.
I'm not that person, but you would have, because you are that person. So, that's it. Let's get to work.
You know what, Ben? We just won't do it at all. Forget this. We're acting like kids, and you're acting like an asshole.
Okay, and I'm the only one? Okay, sorry. Sorry.
No, I'm not fighting you every step of the way. It's not worth it.
We're not fighting.
I think you and I were just, we're never gonna get it together, you know? We're just never gonna work it out.
We'll work it out.
Not this time. I'm done.
Done with what?
With everything, okay? Look, Ben, we're not in high school anymore, and we're not rich and famous. Obviously, somewhere along the lines, all the plans that we discussed in the cafeteria, they didn't pan out. So maybe we should just grow the hell up and we'll focus on something else.
Okay, relax. We'll just work on Catcher for a while.
Gotta go, man.
Where?
It's almost 4, so.
Okay, when are you coming back?
Listen. Hear that? Hear that?
Yeah, did you order food or something?
No. Can you come sit next to me?
No.
It could be Casey.
You hate Casey.
No, man, I don't. Just go get the door.
It's the script.
What?
I think it's knocking.
I don't understand. Does it have, like, a little hand or something?
Shut up.
Have you read Christine?
About the car?
We're gonna die.
No, it doesn't have a knife or something. It's just sitting there quietly, like.
I'm so out of here.
Good, go hide under my bed.
I will.
Fruit?
Where's the fruit?
Oh, good one. Okay, script, you want a piece of Ben Affleck? You got a piece of Ben Affleck. Hi, this is Matt Damon. Hi, it's Matt Damon. Hi, it's Matt Damon. I'm calling for a Mr. Zimmerman? Mr. George Zimmerman? No, I'm actually calling. Oh! I spoke to you, right. Right. Look, about earlier, I'm calling to ask about what was said. Yeah, what you said. No, I remember what I said. I said it. Okay. I'm supposed to come in for an audition at 4. For the play. Oh, I'm in the play. No, that's great. Yeah, great for me. That's tops. All right, thank you very much. Also, one more thing, I might be late. You should get used to that, I'm late to a lot of things. Yeah. And one more thing, I'm not a real blonde, like I said on my audition sheet. Yeah, I'm a big fat liar. Okay, thank you, bye.
Is it safe? You brought it back in, are you nuts?
It's nothing, it was just some kids screwing around. Almost 4, you should go see your mom. Make sure to tell her I hope she feels better.
Okay. Wait.
What, you're not gonna see her?
Well.
Why?
Ben.
She's not sick?
No.
At all?
Come on, look, I.
No, don't. It makes me sick, man.
Wait. I.
Don't. You lied. I set you up, and now you're busted.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
What was I supposed to say, Ben?
What the hell, man? You act like a normal person. You say, hey, Ben, I got a part in a play.
Yeah, right. And you would have been all, oh, that's great, buddy. And then you would have got real quiet and moped around. And then you would have started to make fun of the play or the part or the director. And then you would warn me about everything that could possibly go wrong. But hey, still, congratulations. Have a good time doing that stupid play.
I would have been happy for you.
You would have been jealous. You are jealous. That's why you're pissed at me.
Hey, don't turn this around on me. You lied. You did the wrong thing, not me.
All right. Congratulations, Ben. You win. You happy?
You think I like going on best friend undercover stakeout patrol? That's not me.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about this.
What the hell? You went through my stuff?
No, you left it on my floor, you moron. I just wish you would have told me.
I didn't know till like 2 hours ago.
No, not about the play. That doesn't matter. I wish you would have told me you didn't want to work on Catcher, because then I could have started working on it by myself. I would have been done by now!
You can't do Catcher because it's a bad idea.
Why? Because you didn't think of it?
Can you listen to me for like 1 minute? Okay, Catcher isn't going to work out for so many reasons that I can't even get into right now, but come on. You know you're not a writer. You're not supposed to be a writer. You're this charismatic action hero, hang off the side of buildings type of guy.
Do you think I'm so stupid that I would actually take that as a compliment?
Ben, I'm being honest. In this industry, you have to play to your strengths.
Please, Nat, spare me this know-it-all bullshit crap. You and your four lines in some movie in the week and your goddamn Harvard attitude when you didn't even graduate? I mean, come on! Don't tell me about the industry and how I should model my career, because what the hell have you done? Oh, right! Nothing except waste my damn time.
I've wasted time. I've wasted your time.
Yes!
I've made you sit here in this filthy apartment and read easy words from a ninth grade book. That's funny, Ben, that you would say that I've wasted your time, because I feel for the past 10 years that you've wasted my time. Yeah, it's not funny, haha. It's funny, like I want to shoot myself.
You know what? Don't use my phone then. It's just that it might have germs on it since this apartment is so filthy. So you might just want to get out, you know? Why don't you just get the hell out?
Right.
Just get out.
I'm not gonna leave that here.
Yeah, and you're not taking it with you.
Ben, let me explain something for you. I'm not gonna leave this here because God would strike me dead if I left it in the hands of someone like you.
Someone like me. Someone who shows up on time. Someone who gives a damn. Someone who people actually like.
Someone who doesn't have any talent.
Nice try. Look at all this money.
Ben, oh, come on.
Finders, keepers, baby.
No. Oh, the tables have turned, compadre.
Come here, Matt.
single page. Oh God! Oh God! Hey, Mrs. Affleck, it's Matthew. Is Ben there? Yeah, it's kind of like an emergency, so if I could... Oh, right now? Like a button-down jean? Is this Casey? Casey, can I... Forget it, just tell him to call me, okay? I didn't mean to treat him bad. I meant to treat him honest, you know, as a friend. I'm sorry. Oh, come on. Do I have to help him out my whole life? Who takes care of me? Hey, Ben. Where are you? Oh, yeah, I'm coming.
Are you okay?
Yeah, sure. Forget it.
Where'd you go? I just went for a walk.
Look, I have to tell you something.
Okay.
You're my best friend.
I know.
Okay. So, the script is gone. I woke up and the pages were just blank and it's just gone. I think maybe it's my punishment. I've been taking you for granted lately and treating you like crap. I don't know why it has to affect you so much too, but I guess that's just part of it. I guess it just does. But I'll make it up to you and whatever you want to work on next, it'll be different.
That's cool. How did it start? Interior bar.
Yes, a South Boston bar.
Great.
Oh, you forgot the...
And the Oscar goes to Ben Affleck and Matt Damon. Damon and Ben Affleck are childhood friends. They appeared together in Chasing Amy and Good Will Hunting, for which Damon received a Best Actor nomination. This is their first Academy Award.